Interested in changing the color of your text? It's just a click away right over here. For this tutorial, we'll be editing the colors of the title text. First, select the title in the timeline and make sure that the playhead is positioned over it. Navigate to the inspector on the top right. If the inspector isn't showing, be sure to toggle this icon. Then click on this text icon to make sure we're in the text inspector. Scroll down a bit. We'll apply the colors to the face of the text, so be sure the face checkbox is selected. And we'll click on Show to show the controls. Make sure this is set to Fill with Color. And below that, we'll see this rectangle, also known as a color well. The color well will display the color of our selected text. Right now, it's white, but let's change it. Click on the color well to open the colors window. This first tab reveals the color wheel. Simply drag across the wheel to select a new color. On the inside of the wheel, it's completely white, and the colors close to the center are desaturated, which means they'll be less vibrant. As you expand outward away from the white, the colors become more bright and saturated. This bar below the circle allows you to darken the colors with black, all the way to zero luminance. And down here, you'll see the color you're selecting in this square. To the right of it is an eyedropper tool. If you click on it, you can copy any color on the screen. As an example, we'll eyedrop the orange from this butterfly footage. And once we have that color, we simply have to drag it into one of these swatches to save it and use it on our text. Imagine the time that this is going to save you. Next, if you navigate to the top of the colors window, you can access more tools for selecting color. You can go to this sliders panel where you can choose from grayscale, RGB colors, CMYK colors, and the hue, saturation, and brightness controls. These give you precise control over how much you want to adjust the selected color. To the right of that, you can access this panel, which lets us choose from different color sets. You can choose from defaults like the Apple color set, developer set, a set of crayon colors, and web save colors, which are colors that will display solid and consistent color on any 8-bit supporting monitor. If you click on this gear, you can create your own set by choosing New. It starts us out with a set called Unnamed 2. We'll rename it by once again clicking on the gear and choosing Rename. Type in a new name and just hit Enter to save. Let's add a new swatch to our set. We happen to have a few saved swatches right here. We'll select this blue. Then click on this plus sign. Double-click a swatch to rename it to something. We'll rename this one too. If we decide we no longer want a color in our set, we can click on this minus symbol. If our set gets larger, we can use this search bar to search for specific color names. Then finally, if you want to remove a set, choose Remove from this menu. This window will pop up to confirm, so click Remove again. Heads up, please subscribe, comment, and share, and like, and do everything you can because this tutorial is awesome. Moving on, the next tab is the Spectrum Palette, where the brightest colors are in the middle and the values move from light to dark. It's actually easier to select pure white in this palette than the color wheel, so keep it in mind. The next one is the Pencils Palette, so you can pick colors that are matched to color pencils
of the same names. Let's exit out of this window by clicking the red X. For the quickest way to choose a color, click on this down arrow next to the color well. The spectrum palette will appear. And at the bottom, there's a simple grayscale. Now you're an expert to finding that perfect color and applying it to your text.
We can go on and on about color controls, but now you know the basics for your next project.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Like, share, subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think in the comments below.